A very good morning, children. Welcome back to our class. Did you observe the project works that I am giving you homework? They are related to our chapters. So don't neglect the project works that I am giving you. Go through the project works also. As we are continuing our chapter number 13, today's session number is 68. So up to page number 132 we have finished. Activity number 6 we have finished. Now we'll continue our lesson, measurement of volume, page number 133. And once again go through the lesson, that is textbook reading is very important because this chapter is very lengthy and you might have forgot the chapter before class. So please go through the chapter once again. Now we'll continue. Measurement of volume. How do you find the volume of a solid? Till now we have learned about the regular surface and the irregular surface. Now about the volume of a solid. Mrs. John is constructing a house. She needs sand and inquired about prices. So when you start constructing a house, you inquire others, know what is the cost of the sand and so on. And the supply informed her that two tractors load of sand cost rupees 4,000 and a lorry load of sand cost rupees 4,000. Which is cheaper for Mrs. John, a lorry load or two tractors load of sand? How can you decide which load has more quantity of sand? So here, two loads of tractor. Two loads of tractor's cost is 4,000 and one load of lorry. This is the cost of sand. Okay. This is also 4,000. So when she is want to construct a house, she has to buy the sand. If she get the two tractors load also, it's 4,000 and one load of lorry is also 4,000. Now how can you decide that which load has more quantity, whether two tractors or one lorry? To decide the quantity contained either in a lorry or a tractor, we need to know the volume of the body of lorry as well as the that of a body of tractor. Volume is the measure of extent of space occupied by a body. So you have to know the volume of the body of a tractor and the body of a lorry. Then we can know whether the lorry or the tractor contains more quantity. Which contains the more quantity? Whether it is a tractor or a lorry. So to know that one, we should know the body of a volume. The volume of the body. Volume is the measure of the extent of space occupied by a body. Now what is the volume? We are learning about the measurement of volume. But what is the volume? This is the definition of the volume. Volume is the, it is there in the textbook, ma. Volume is a measure of the extent of space occupied by a body. Now this is the space and it is occupied by a body. So to know the measurement, this is called as a volume. This is the measurement of the space that is occupied by the body and this is known as a volume. Now first of all we have to know the volume of the tractor and the volume of the lorry. Next, measurements of volume of liquids. Now this is about the solid we have gone through. Now the measurement of the volume of liquids. How can you measure the volume of kerosene? How do you decide the volume of milk? We use some measuring cylinders to measure the volumes of liquids such as kerosene, milk, oil, water. These are the liquids, no? The volume of the liquids is expressed in liters or milliliters. When you are measuring the volume of the liquids, we'll measure it in liters and milliliters. Apart from measuring the volumes of liquid, we also measure the volumes of solids, for example, loose solids like sand, clay and ready mix of cement. Not only liquids, and sometimes we'll measure the volume of the solids like loose solids like sand, clay and ready mix or cement. Now what is the standard unit of measuring the volume of solids? Are you able to measure the volume of loose solids? How can you decide a standard unit of volume of a solid? This we are going to learn now. And they have given here measuring cylinder. This is also very important. It is a cylinder in cylindrical in shape. This is called as a measuring cylinder and this is in cylindrical shape with graduations marked on its body. Like this, 10, 20, 30, these are the graduations they have marked on the measuring cylinder. Measuring cylinders are available in different sizes. They are used in laboratories to measure a certain volume of liquid and to measure milk, oils, etc. These are used in the laboratory. We can fill it with the liquid to be measured and then read the markings at the lowest point of the concave surface of the liquid. We must bring our eyes in line with this level of liquid when and then read it. So, when you are measuring in the measuring cylinder, these graduation marks are there. So, you have to bring your eyes in a line to the surface of this measuring cylinder and the level. Then, we have to mark it when you are measuring. This is how you have to measure in a measuring cylinder. Look at figure number 18. There are certain number of identical cubes of length, breadth and height 1 cm each. And a cardboard box of length 3 cm, breadth cm and height 2 cm. Here they have given in the figure number 18. So these are the cubes and this is a cardboard. Place 3 cubes in a line so as to cover the entire length. Along the side of this line, place another line of 3 cubes so as to completely cover the base of the box. How many cubes have you used so far? How many cubes do you need to cover the entire empty space in the box? Place more cubes over this set of blocks so that the total space is occupied by the blocks. Calculate the number of cubes occupying the rectangular box. How many cubes occupy the rectangular box? Can you guess the volume of a rectangular box? So, this is one more example to know the volume of a solid. Let us see. They are asking to take a rectangular cardboard box and small cubes. They have given the length, breadth and the height. So each cube this is a cube. This is a cube and each cube is having 1 cm length and 1 cm breadth and 1 cm height. That is, one cube is equal to 1 centimeter into 1 centimeter into 1 centimeter. That is length into breadth into height. This is known as 1 cubic centimeter. So, 1 cube is equal to 1 cubic centimeter, which is known as 1 cubic centimeter, and it is written as like this. Is it clear? Now, cubic centimeter is the standard unit of measurement of a volume of solids. Now, what is the standard unit to measure the volume of the solid? It is called as the cubic centimeter. Cubic centimeter is the standard unit when you want to measure the volume of a solid. Therefore, the volume of a rectangular cardboard box is equal to the total number of cubes occupying it. Now, we have to know the volume of a rectangular box. This is a rectangular cardboard box. Now, how do you know the volume of the rectangular box? Now, place the cubes 1, 2, 3, 4... 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24. So, think this is the rectangular box and we have placed the cubes like this. This is in a one row. And suppose it is in the three rows. Now, each row it contains 25. And three rows it will contain 75 cubes. That means a cardboard, rectangular cardboard occupied 75 cubes in this cardboard. Now, what is the volume of the rectangular cardboard? This is equal to 75 cubes. 75 cubes into 1 cubic centimeter. That is, 75 cubic centimeter is the volume of a rectangular box. So, therefore, the volume of a rectangular cardboard box is equal to 12 into 1 cubic centimeter is equal to 12 cubic centimeter. However, if you multiply the length and the breadth and the height, it would be the same. So, here they have given example that it contains 12 cubes. Then it is equal to 12 cubic centimeter. And already, height, length and the breadth they have given of the rectangular box. Here they have given a cardboard box. Is the length is equal to 3 centimeters, breadth is equal to 2 centimeters and height is equal to 2 centimeters. That means length, breadth and height. 3 into 2, 2, 2, 6 and 6 is 12 cubic centimeter. So indirectly you can measure in this way. Otherwise you can measure the number of cubes into cubic centimeter. So therefore we can say the volume of a box is equal to length, breadth and height. So what is the volume of a cardboard box? Length, breadth and height. Do you know, we must have noticed that the volumes of liquids are written in ml while those of solids are written in cubic centimeters. So in the volume of the liquids like kerosene, oil and milk, it is measured in milliliters and liters, and when you are measuring the solids it is equal to cubic centimeter. Do you know the relation between these two units? The two units are related as follows. 1 ml is equal to 1 cubic centimeter. This is also very important one. 1 milliliter is equal to 1 cubic centimeter. Note this point. Okay. Now measurement of volume of irregular solids using a measuring cylinder. Take a measuring cylinder and fill almost half of it with water. Record the volume of water. Let us assume it as a cubic centimeter or a milliliter. Now tie a small irregular solid with a fine cotton thread. Put the solid gently into the water in the cylinder so that it is completely immersed in water. What changes do you notice in the water level of a cylinder? You may notice that the level of your water is in the measuring cylinder rises as the stone displaces water equal to its own volume. Record the new volume of water. Let us assume that it be BML. Now the volume of stone will be the difference between the second volume of the first volume, that is volume of the stone is equal to B minus A cubic centimeter. Let us see now. Now they are asking to take a measuring cylinder. Think this is the measuring cylinder and fill it half of the measuring cylinder with water. Now mark here. Think this is the AML. That means it may be a 5 ml of water or something. So we have to mark like this. Now take a stone and tie it with a thread. Simply I am not using the thread. When you put the stone, what happens? The water level rises. Now when you put a stone in the water, what happens? The water level rises up to this mark. And mark here BML. So to know the volume of this stone, what we have to do is, volume of the stone is equal to B minus A cubic centimeter. B may be 8 ml and think that A is 5 ml, then it will be 3 cubic centimeters. This is the volume of a stone. Okay, right. So in this way we have to measure the volume of a stone in a measuring cylinder. Here already it will be marked, but I have taken a glass, so there are no graduation marks. So in the measuring cylinder there will be the graduation marks, and when you tie the thread to a stone and when you just immerse in a measuring cylinder, then the water level automatically it will be rises. So in this way you have to measure the volume of a cylinder. So this is a lengthy lesson and we have learned lot of matter in this lesson, like the irregular surface area, how to measure. Almost the lesson contains the measurement, but we have learned in a different types of measurements, maybe the volume of a solid, the volume of a liquid, how to measure irregular surface on the graph paper, so on. Just see what we have learned in this chapter once again. We use some conventional ways like hand span, foot span, cubit, etc. for the rough measurements in our daily life. This is the important point that we have learned. Next, we need standard units to measure the lengths accurately. Meter scale is a standard instrument to measure the length. Meter is the standard unit for measuring length. Larger distance can be measured in kilometers. Area is the measure of the extent of the plane surface occupied by an object. Generally, we measure area in square meters or square centimeters, etc. Volume is a measure of extent of the space occupied by a body, just we have learned. Volume of solids is measured in cubic meters or cubic centimeters. Next, the volume of liquids is measured in the milliliter, that is equal to 1 cubic centimeter. That is 1 milliliter is equal to 1 cubic centimeter. In other way, you can say that 3 cubic centimeter is equal to 3 ml. So this is all, children. We have finished our chapter and your homework is write the question answers from this lesson. Question number 8, 9 and 11, 12. Here they have not given the 10th question. So, okay, so question number 8, 9, 11, 12. These four question answers from the textbook. Look into the workbook and write one time. This is your homework. When you are writing, please make sure that you have to learn this question and answers. Okay, children, thank you. And don't, your handwriting is not good. So, don't do like that. When you are sending me, please mention your name, class, and send me in time and write neatly. So, every day we are giving you some instructions. Follow the instructions and listen the full video. Not only the homework video and the starting video. Not like that. You have to listen the full video. And make sure that when you are sending your homework, please write your name. And this is all for your children today. Thank you.